In this video, we're going to run a benchmark test between AWS Lambda and Google Cloud Functions. Recently, Google Cloud introduced a new generation of Cloud Functions. They call it Gen 2. It's simply a wrapper around Cloud Run, which brings even more confusion. For example, in the previous generation, to allow unauthenticated access to the function, you would need to grant Cloud Functions Invoker role to all users. Since Gen 2 is a wrapper around Cloud Run, now to achieve the same result, you would need to grant Cloud Run Invoker to the Cloud Functions. In the first benchmark test, to establish a baseline, we will create a simple function that returns hello world and invoke that function using its URL 1000 times. In the second test, we will download a large image from the S3 or JS bucket, depending on the cloud, then resize it to 400 by 400 pixels and save the result back to the bucket. Then, based on the results, we will design a third benchmark test. In AWS, you can only give memory to your Lambda function. It allocates CPU power in proportion to the amount of memory configured. For example, if you need one virtual CPU, you would provide 1769 MB of memory to your function. There are a bunch of other parameters, but those are the most important ones. Google Cloud Functions uses similar proportions. We're going to allocate the same amount of memory for both functions, which is 1 GB, which results in a little bit more than a half of the virtual CPU. Also, how quickly Lambda and Cloud Functions can afterscale based on the load will play an important role in this test. You can find the source code for the functions as well as Terraform to reproduce this benchmark test in my GitHub repository. If you run Terraform Apply, you'll get a few URLs that you can use to test your functions. To run a benchmark, we're going to use a Hey tool. It's a tiny Golang app that sends some load to a web application. First of all, let's test AWS Lambda Hello World function. There are a few arguments that we need to supply to Hey. First, we want to perform 1000 requests. Then we want to spin up 5 workers to run some requests in parallel. Also, specify the get method and provide the URL for the function to invoke. It doesn't have any output while it's running. In the results, you can find information about the slowest request, fastest, and average, and a bunch of other stuff, and how many requests per second it served. You also get a histogram with response distribution. Here, for example, the average time of the requests is 119 milliseconds. Also, it's important to take a look at the latency distribution and especially how long it took to complete 95 and 99% of all requests. For simplicity, I will just compare average time. Next, let's run exactly the same Hello World Google Cloud function. The results are slightly better. The average time is only 110 milliseconds, which is around 8% faster. And we got 44 requests per second instead of 41 with Lambda. I don't think that you should rely on these particular benchmarks, except that we proved that our serverless functions work. We can also take a look at the concurrent execution. That's how many functions were created to serve the traffic. In AWS, when you run shard tests, metrics are not very accurate, but still we can see that Lambda scaled from 1 instance to 3. GCP also spun up 3 cloud functions for the Hello World test. Now let's take a look at another function to resize the image. We have 3 Golang functions: getImage to download object from the bucket, uploadImage to save a new scaled down image to the bucket, and scaleImage to resize the image. In GCP, we use Google Cloud SDK, so the code will be slightly different, but the same logic. To test AWS Lambda that resizes the image, grab the URL and use the same load test tool. This test takes around 8 to 10 minutes to complete. In the results, we have the average duration, which is 2.38 seconds, and 2 requests per second. 95% of all requests were completed under 2.8 seconds. Now run the same test with a Google Cloud function to resize the image. The results are significantly slower. The average duration is above 3 seconds, and we only completed 1.5 requests per second, which is 36% slower than AWS. During this benchmark, AWS created 5 instances of the Lambda function to resize the image. On the other hand, Google doubles it to almost 10 functions. Let's run the final test, in which we're going to use AWS Lambda, but instead of using S3, we're going to download image from the Google storage bucket, resize it, and upload it back. Basically, the same thing that Google Cloud Function does. To grant permissions, you need to get credentials file and put it into your Lambda function and use environment variable. Results are a little bit surprising. AWS Lambda's average duration is 2.47 seconds, which is still 31% faster than native Google Cloud Function. To conclude, AWS Lambda is significantly faster than Google Cloud Function. The reason, in my opinion, would be the amount and quality of CPU that is allocated to the function. Based on the official data, in AWS, you get one virtual CPU with 1,769 MB of memory, and in GCP, you need 2 GB to get one virtual CPU. There are other parameters that can affect the function performance, such as networking and afterscaling. Let me know in the comments why you think cloud functions are slower. Thank you for watching. Take a look at another benchmark between AWS Lambda written in Golang versus Rust. You will be surprised by the results.